I never met my biological father, but I have met my biological mother. And unfortunately, she couldn't take care of me when I was younger because she had some hard times with the law and she wrestled with addiction. As a result, I was put into foster homes, and at about the age of one, I was fostered by the family that would later adopt me. Now, I mention this because in my teenage years, as I started looking into faith and worldviews, something stood out to me that the Bible presented, and it was this. The Apostle Paul says in Romans 8 and Galatians 4 and Ephesians 1 that God adopts us as his sons and we can call him Father. And this really, really grabbed me. So I want to share with you 6 reasons why God adopting us as sons and daughters not only makes sense in his kingdom, but is actually quite beautiful. First, adopted kids are always saved from something. See, personally, I was saved from a mother who was battling with addiction, and I was saved from a life of potential instability. And with God, it's the same. I'm saved from punishment from sin. I'm saved from God's anger and his wrath. And I'm also saved from an eternity away from God. Secondly, adoption is free for me, but it's really costly for my parents. My parents had to spend a lot of time, a lot of emotional energy, and they actually had to spend a lot of money. I even know a couple who had to spend $12,000 to adopt their child. Whilst for me, I get shelter, I get education, and I get love and stability. And it's the same with God and his kingdom. Free for me to enter into his kingdom, but it cost God his life when he came down as the man Jesus and died a death on the cross. Thirdly, adopted kids do nothing to deserve being adopted. See, I was just a chubby baby, so chubby that it looked like I had elastic bands up and down my wrists and my arms. All I did was eat, I contributed nothing, I only took. And in God's kingdom, we don't contribute a thing to the act of salvation. Jesus does it all to pay our debt. Fourth, adoption gives you a safe and secure identity. See, when I was 9, my adoption certificate came through, which meant before that, I could have been taken away at any time. But when the certificate came through, I was safe. I was my parents' son. I enjoyed the rights and the privileges of being my parents' son. Didn't matter how good I was, didn't matter how bad I was my parents' son. And in the kingdom of God, doesn't matter how good I am or how bad I am his child. It's super safe, it's super secure. Fifth, adoption gives us access to the Father. See, when I got adopted, I could call my dad, Dad, and not just by his first name. And when I was at his workplace, I could just walk straight in. The other employees had to wait for him, they had to book, but I'd just look at the receptionist and go, I'm his son. And it's the same with God. We don't just call him Master or King or Creator or Lord. We get to call him Father and have a relationship with him like a father and a child. And lastly, adoption gives you a new family, a new community. See, when I got adopted, I got a mum, a dad, I got a sister who's also adopted, and I got grandparents. And with God's kingdom, it's the same. I have brothers and sisters in Christ. I call God Father, and I call my Savior Jesus my brother. So there you have it. God grants us rights and privileges and access and intimacy that is unique to Christianity. Hopefully you see why it grabbed me, and perhaps it appeals to you too.